For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to techarkit YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that expect command making the automation simple, and this makes very easy to log into the remote servers without username and password. You can simply answer those username and password questions using the expect on an interactive session. So automatically you can pass the username and password to that SSH session, so you can run the commands on the multiple servers using this expect language. Let's see what exactly the expect is to and how you can utilize the expect. So expect is a program that talks to other interactive programs according to a script. Following the script, except knows what can be expected from a program and what the correct response should be. An interpreted language provides branching and high-level control structures to direct a dialogue. In addition, the user can take control and interact directly when desired, afterward returning control to the script. So this is simply easy and perfect method to respond to a program. So it interactive programs according to the script. So example, if you want to say that you run a SSH to the remote server and it asks you the username and password, using the expect you can answer those questions. So this is my username and this is the password. So what happens, it will automatically log into that server, and if you want to run some command on the remote server, you can simply answer those questions and it will run the command on the remote server and come back to the again to the normal terminal control. So that's the simple expect can do using the provides most automation skill set for you. Expect scripting language is used to feed input automatically to an interactive program. So that's what the expect do. What you can do with the expect, okay? Cause your computer to dial you back so that you can log in without paying for the call. Start a game, and if the optimal configuration does not appear, restart it. Until it does, then hand over control to you. So example, start a game, the game is not optimal configuration, so you want to reboot it, but when it comes to the optimal control, optimal you don't know, so how many times you wanted to reboot. But so using the expect, what it can do is that it can reboot how many times you want, then after the optimal session, so it gives you the control. So that's what it can do. Run FSCK, and in response to its questions, answer yes, no, or give control you back based on a predetermined criteria. Example, say you run FSCK on the file without Y option, then it will keep on asking you that this file wanted to repair. Do you say yes or no? Then if you run a FSCK on a larger file system, example, you contain a 1 lakh or 1 million files on that disk, then what happens out of that, if you have a thousands of files you want to answer, then you should be saying yes, 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 no, 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 so many times. Instead of that, you can run FSCK and say expect to say yes or no. So if you say repeatedly, the expect will take care automatically say yes, 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 yes. So the FSCK will complete without your saying an interaction yes, no. So the expect will automatically take care those answers, then your program FSCK will complete. Connect to another network or BBS and automatically retrieve your mail so that it appears at if it was original sent to your local system. So example, say if you want to connect to the another network system or automatically retrieve your mails, so that can also be you can do using the expect. Carry environment variables, current directory, or any kind of information across R login, telnet, tip, su, ch group, etc. So this is very simple and easy to carry your environment variables or the current directory and kind of information. So while you do the R login, SSH, telnet, or SU, switching the user from one user to another user and changing the group ownership like ch group. So what are the processes it contains and what those useful? So these are the simple processes it contains. Say that send is to send the string to the process. Expect, wait for the specific string from the process. Example, say you run some command, and in that example you run user login, right? Then it will ask you for the password. So you can say expect this string, example the password is a string, wait for the string, then respond. So that's what the expect do. Span to start the command. Interact, the interact command allows you to interact with your program. This means that the interact command, it says to expect command to release the terminal so you can write things and do things. Puts, so puts is simply like echo out the text. Simple, like whenever you write the echo, simple place, replace the echo and puts. So you can use the puts. So let's see how this expect can works on the practical session, and we do some practical scripts and do the session. So here is the server which I have, and I have also implemented few shell scripts or the few except scripts which can do the what we want. Okay, so example, I have some questions, this questions.sh file here. Let's say what I'm doing is simple echo command. Let's say that hi, and it should get the reply saying that what is the hi. So somebody is saying hi, then it's a you say hi. Then someone is asking the question saying that how are you, then you should say I am fine. Then echo, so it says that what's your name, then you say your name. So this is the questions. So if I run this example, the questions here, it says that hi, then I say hi, how are you? So I am fine. What is your name? My name is Ravi. Simple that. So it is asking the questions, you are answering that. But instead of that, so it will automatically answer your question using the expect. How it going to answer? You can see that get answers. So this is the expect command. So example, what I'm doing here is that expect timeout is going to minus one time, so it won't timeout. And span, so I'm running this question dot sh, and while running, so expect, what is there here, echo hi. Hi is the message, look for the hi, then whenever you get the hi, send saying that hi, that is the answer. And look for the how are you string, then send I am fine. Expect what's your name, then send my name is Ravi, and then expect is EOF. Now let's clear the screen and run this answer.sh. Now see what happened. It runs the questions.sh file, then the question file says hi, then it answers hi, then it says how are you, the answer is I am fine. What's your name, then it says my name is Ravi. So this simple is that it's going to answer your question automatically. That's fine. But what you can utilize the same expect on your real time to automate your stuff, how you can automate this using the expect. So here is an example I have made, which is SSH to the remote host and run some commands on that remote host and come back. So it's simple is that is the simple example of this script, except script. So I'm echoing saying that puts get a new line and get a host name and say span, run this command SSH to the server and host name, run the host name command on that server and come back. So whenever you see that expect that it is asking for the password, then send that this is my password, then send that password. So that what happens, it runs the command host name on that remote server and ask for the password. The password will be sent, then it will return the host name. Then again I am just echoing that get the df command output here, and again it's going to SSH to the server and run the df-h command on the remote server. Then it will expect the password to be provided, then this sends the password, then again it back come back to your interactive terminal. Okay, so this is the simple script. Let's see sshd.sh. Now let's execute this script. Enter. I can see that. So the remote server is, it sends the host name, okay, and it get back that host name details, and again it's come back and it's execute the df-h command, and you get the df-h command output. So here is my server. You can see this is 192.168.175.130, and this is the command output. Example, if I edit this sshd dot here and I can go back again, I just comment here simple. So now I just commented this. Now save this script and just run to get only the host name. You can see the host name is SMB server techarkit. Now if you go to this here and see this host name, this is the SMB server techarkit is the host name of this server. And if you see what is this local host name, it's a podman-techarkit. That simple is that you can use this expect command to send a interact, so you can answer the programs whenever the program is asking any questions, you can answer automatically using this expect. That's about this expect command. I hope this will be very, very useful for you to do the automation. Happy automation. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses.